So in answer to a question some of you are asking, why does Gerard film these little talks? I'm paying the kid $1 million. The least he can do is film a little talk. Well, that's all. Yeah, he's getting paid $1 million. So am I. I'm getting paid $2 million. Yeah, very good. You laugh no harder. Okay. But that way, if you don't get to Mass and you want to watch a short little talk, they're always on YouTube, Facebook, just go on Mary Mother God, and you'll see it, and they're always very brief, et cetera, et cetera. So that's why Gerard does this. One Mass a week. So in the 60s or 70s, the wildly popular Broadway play, Godspell, made popular the line, "Prepare ye the way of the Lord." Prepare, you know, it's just catchy, etc. And it made one line of scripture maybe stick in the mind. And we heard it twice today, "Prepare the way of the Lord." Melissa had it in the first reading, and it's in the gospel. It is not our strong point. Preparation is not our strong point. We are much better at Lent than Advent. Really, Catholics and Christians in general are good. Catholics in particular, Ash Wednesday, fasting, prayer, almsgiving, you know, giving no meat on Friday. We're very good at Lent. That's about repair. But prepare, we're not real good at. We're not. I would say Advent is probably the least effective of our seasons. Maybe it's an American trait that we don't prepare well for things. I mean, think about it. The day before yesterday, we celebrated Pearl Harbor, or remember Pearl Harbor. I mean, it was no secret that the tension between the Japanese Empire and America was at a boiling point. You know, war was going to happen soon, and yet they were caught, you know, asleep at the switch on that Sunday morning so many years ago. Some of you remember it, I don't. And 2,400 of our men and women died. How could we not be prepared? But it happened. We don't prepare well. Maybe we're a people of today, not looking so much ahead. I don't know. But it's certainly true when it comes to Advent. We are not good at prepare as much as repair. I think part of the reason is, especially for us in the religious sense here, is that Advent preparation really requires three things: simplicity, solitude, and silence. Like a focus. Like every player on the field has talent, only some can really focus. You know, that's what Advent has to be. We're all into it, but you know, how can you have simplicity when there's so much to do? It's just hard. Those of you who bake and stuff like that, I don't have to do any of that stuff, but there's a deadline. You have to have it done by this day. It's hard to be simple when you got 20, you know, packages in your hand coming home from the mall. Solitude, it just seems like there's more people around at this time of the year. Kids are coming home from school, families coming home from Christmas, praise God, but now I got more to do. You know, I eat most of my meals alone. For better or worse, I kind of enjoy that solitude. You know, you don't have that when you have kids and stuff. And silence, it's just a loud time of the year. Even the Christmas carols are loud, there's noise. And because of all that going on, it's hard to prepare. Because you need those things. Simplicity, solitude, silence. Having any one of them is hard. But if we can master those things, maybe some of us do it better than others, then we listen better to the readings. And we get the points that will point us to a healthy Advent. Like he says, maybe you didn't catch it, in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. In the desert, the place where the cactus plant grows, not the evergreen tree. In other words, Advent has to be going out into places that maybe you don't want to go, where there used to be life, but it's been deserted. Seriously, I know people who sent 500 Christmas cards. And that's fine. The post office needs the business. I'd rather you write one heartfelt note that might take an hour to somebody who you know doesn't get many Christmas cards at all. I'd rather you write one than 500, if the one is written well. That's going to a person who feels deserted. Now you're checking the mailbox to see, did I get anything today? Used to do that with guys in school. They never got anything. They had a mailbox, that little slot, you could tell. They never got anything. They were young. What about the old person, who's the only one left in the family? Or bake a couple dozen cookies and bring them up the alley. There's six floors. Each floor has 50 or so residents. And just go to any floor and say to the head nurse, who doesn't get many visitors? And that's not easy to do. It's kind of the desert. Those are kind of lonely places, you know, nursing homes. But you go and you do that, you come home feeling so rich. So rich. Or a phone call, you know, out to somebody who's kind of in the desert. But you have to have the silence and the solitude to say, that's what I really need to do. But if you have the silence and the solitude, you'll do it, and you'll have the energy, and you'll have the desire to do it. See how that happens? Well, you have to have the preparation before you get the action. So this time, you know, last two or 3 weeks ago in Philadelphia, there was a fire at a nursing home, and four people died. They said that the fire was so intense, it melted the helmets on the firefighters. I've never heard of that before. In Paoli, outside Philadelphia. And they were talking in the paper, didn't they prepare? Most of the people that have Alzheimer's or dementia, they don't know their own names. Are they going to remember an escape route? That ain't going to happen. And four people dying, older people. They weren't prepared. That can't happen for us. Pray for simplicity, solitude, and silence to detect who's in the desert that needs my love, that needs a call, a car, a cookie. And you'll find there's a great, rich Advent experience. And Christmas will come to you. Not easy to do, it's not. I struggle with it. Busy. Maybe we're too busy. Let us stand, my friends, and we'll profess our faith.